There's the players who dominate when the lights get brighter.
Shoot. Kawhi makes his move.
In this video, we'll count down the top five NBA playoff chokers in 2021 by looking at how their play mightily fell off from the regular season. Stay tuned, because you're not going to believe who's ranked number one on this list. Number five, Russell Westbrook. We love the triple-double averages, but to not be known as a playoff choker, we have to see Russ raise his efficiency in the playoffs as opposed to have it fall off. Russ was a minus 21 in Game 5 against the Sixers when Philly would close out Washington, and for the series, he made 32.4% of his jumpers and a shockingly brutal 18% of his threes. Now, Westbrook's never been known for his highly efficient play, but at least in the 72-game season, his shooting splits were respectable. But for the Washington faithful in round one this year, simply put, he was a complete abomination, as the former MVP shot 3-for-19 from the field in Game 3. As I said, I have a ton of respect for the triple-doubles and everything the future Hall of Famer has achieved throughout his career, but the game where he shot 3-for-19 was the first Wizards playoff game in nearly 4 years, and the fans who bought tickets deserved a much better shooting night from Brody. For whatever reason, every year in the playoffs, Westbrook's efficiency falls off a cliff. So if he wants to stay as a second scoring option, then he has to bring a better focus in 2022. But maybe he needs to consider eliminating the three-point shot from his game entirely, because in now 7 separate postseasons, Westbrook's shot under 30% from distance. Number 4, Julius Randle. The Knicks' number one scoring option was also a first-time All-Star in 2021, but the most improved player of the year didn't carry his play over to the postseason. Randle shot the lowest field goal percentage of any player in the postseason, which put a stain on New York's first playoff appearance in nearly a decade. Whether it was the sticky defense of DeAndre Hunter, the bright lights of the playoffs, or simply the fact that the Hawks' game plan had him figured out, Randle wasn't able to score at anywhere near the rate he did during the regular season. The Knicks ended up getting taken care of by Trae Young and company in a swift 5 games, but through the first 3 games of the series, Randle had attempted 54 shots and made a measly 13 of them. That pretty much says it all. Hopefully Julius learns from this and knows what it takes to be a number one option in the playoffs next time around. Number 3, Ben Simmons. His free throw percentage has been the worst among any player by a whopping 20%. Shooting 32.8% from the free throw line in the postseason, not even this Sixers fan who put up a valiant effort trying to teach Simmons how to shoot them could stop the brick house that was being built in front of our eyes and is still being built. Considering in the 72-game season, Ben made his free throws at nearly double the rate than he did in the playoffs, this is undeniably a choke job. Sixer fans have had to suffer through a lot over the years, and I must say their playoff collapse was fairly predictable. Other than the vid you're watching right now, I'm almost always making positive content hyping up different teams and players, but aside from one Joel Embiid vid earlier in the year about how he was an MVP favorite, I've ignored the Sixers. And the lack of floor spacing that Simmons provides, given he can't even think about taking a jumper, that had everything to do with the lack of Sixer content I've posted. I just didn't have much belief in them from the start. Maybe a video on what Philadelphia must do to become contenders is in order, and that'll likely involve trading the Aussie. Number 2, the Utah Jazz, other than Donovan Mitchell. I'm not taking any credit away from Coach Tyronn Lue, as well as Paul George and the breakout rookie Terrence Mann. The Clippers, maybe even Mann specifically, deserve a separate video made about them. However, the Utah Jazz took a 25-point lead in the third quarter of Game 6, and without Kawhi playing for the Clippers in the last 2 games of the series, Utah failed to take advantage. After taking a commanding 2-0 series lead, maybe I overreacted by making a video on how the Jazz were built for the finals, but I don't take that back, because even though they didn't live up to expectations, Utah had every piece intact in order to get through to the finals. But I'm going to pin their disappointing results on a few things. A, the three-time Defensive Player of the Year, Rudy Gobert, being a minus 24 in Game 6 and getting dunked on throughout the entire series, and B, the Sixth Man of the Year, Jordan Clarkson, making a combined 14 of his 46 field goals in Games 1, 3, and 4, and also going scoreless in the second half of Game 6. Mike Conley was just returning from injury, so we can't blame him too much for shooting 1 of 8. Overall, though, D. Mitch was electric throughout this whole series and had very little help on both ends of the floor. I expected Gobert to be more of a leader when his team hit a drought, but instead, that was all on Mitchell. So, a monumental folding from the number one seeded Jazz. Well, 98% of them. We'll see what the offseason has in store for Utah. Number one, Doc Rivers. Death, taxes, and a Doc Rivers coach team getting cocky when they're up in a series and mightily choking. The three certainties in life. In 2003, when Doc was coaching the Orlando Magic, they took a 3-1 series lead against the Detroit Pistons and coughed that up. In 2015, Doc's Lob City Clippers choked a 3-1 series lead to the Houston Rockets, with Rivers becoming the first coach in league history to blow multiple 3-1 leads, but he wasn't done there. I guess after 5 years went by, Doc had forgotten about that record-setting feat, because in the bubble last year, again his squad got overconfident. In the second round, the Clippers led the Nuggets 3-1 and completely let their guard down, as they got lit up by the Blue Arrow Jamal Murray, who torched them in three straight games to stun a Doc Rivers-led team. That led to the veteran coach's firing, but he was immediately given another job with the Philadelphia 76ers, and again, Doc had to learn his lesson. In this year's second round, with massive leads in games 4 and 5, specifically an 18-point lead in game 4 and a 26-point lead in game 5, the Sixers collapsed and went on to lose both of those games. I know the Sixers just won in Atlanta to force a game 7, but the Hawks have no business being in this series. All due respect to Trae Young, I've made videos on the Hawks in the past, but really, the Sixers should have taken care of business by now. Now you may be thinking, D-Flo, how can a coach be a choker? Well, the fact that Doc has coached 4 different playoff teams this century, and they've all fell apart after going ahead, is far from a coincidence. A coach is 100% responsible for the mantra of their team, and in every instance of his team choking, Doc's guys clearly took their foot off the gas pedal. When you take such a convincing series lead, it's on your coach to say, "Hey y'all, the job's not done yet." Blame the players on Doc's team all you want, and I did that with Ben Simmons, but Doc earns the number one spot on this list because this has happened 4 times now. And I'll see you next video.